to save budget. You know, parts are expensive sometimes, so any way to cut costs. I would cut costs other places before I went there, or cut it but still keep it.
I feel like the biggest part of that, the biggest issue with, you know, cutting your AdWords off is giving up that real estate to a competitor.
Absolutely.
I don't think anybody really, I don't think anybody wants to give that
Absolutely.
Their brand recognition, you know, at all. So I think, you know, for that fact, it's kind of invaluable to just have your ad there where your competitors aren't showing. And when you're showing, your competitor's ad isn't showing in whatever spot you're showing in. So, you know, for that fact, you know, I'd rather have my ads up there.
Yeah, Casey, can you talk about real quick just how long it would take someone, how much time and effort just to get the organic there versus how quickly you can get using AdWords?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, AdWords, it takes us about, you know, a couple hours to set up your store. And as soon as we put your credit card information in there, we have the AdWords, we have the keywords set out where you want to show up, you're showing up right away. You're on top, you're number one, two, or three usually when we set you up. For organic search results, it's a lot different. I mean, I think a lot of you can attest to, you know, our store started, you know, a week ago, why are we not showing up? This is crazy, we're not on the first page at all. It takes a lot of time. You know, most stores see 2 to 3 months before they're showing up on the first page, before the results are showing up, you know, even near the top three. So, you know, it's really nice to have your AdWords kicking off and running, you know, the first day you're open, so you're showing up top.
And Corey, can you just talk about how much work it would go into that to build your organic? Because it's not just an overnight.
Organic is, I mean, we have a strong website, which is great. The team's really built that out to be really primed for user experience. They go there, it's exactly what they're looking for. It makes sense. Lots and lots of keywords on all those pages. But we usually have to use Yext, Facebook, all these different reviews to build that organic. And as you guys know, reviews don't happen overnight. All this different activity by customers doesn't happen overnight at all. And it can take 2 to 3 months to start showing up in the place you want to be in Google, just naturally. Compared to AdWords, a local competitor could open up and set a decent amount of budget for their first few weeks, first few months, whatever, and show up above you that first day if you don't have an AdWords campaign.
Dave, you have a question?
So in relation to what we've been talking about, should we scale our Google AdWords campaign with our sales? We're established, we've been around a year, we're up around 50 now, and organically we're showing up, just like Robert too, we're like usually in the top three organically as well as our Google AdWords. So should we scale our AdWords campaign, you know, if we want to continue that growth like you were talking about, if we want to get up to 80, 90 grand in sales, do we need to continue to scale that budget, or will the same budget we're using now help us get there without having to increase it any?
Definitely scale. I would say scale is huge. You know, like I said, as you continue to gain history throughout your AdWords campaign, with time, it gets better. The cost becomes lower because people are clicking on your ads. More you have that history where they're saying, okay, I want to pair, I'll click on this because it makes the most sense. So as we optimize and get better, the cost will go down. So you build more room to be able to allow more clicks throughout the day.
Get a bigger bang for your dollar, though.
Absolutely.
Exactly.
That's what happens.
Yeah. I would expand, you know, as much as you can. You know, some of our bigger stores, I mean, we have the Fort Myers area. They're on their own group account now. But before we even went on their group account, they were spending, the Fort Myers account, I think, spent $120 a day, $150 a day. So, yeah, with growth, that would definitely be
seen. That was a group?
That was, as a group, they're spending about $350.
Yeah, that was when he had his own store, right?
A single store for Myers was spending about.
But he's doing $100,000 a month.
Maybe you all forgot that that's
not. He's doing $100,000. Yeah, he's doing $100,000 a month. Exactly.
Really briefly, I wanted to ask you a quick question about organics. We pop up as number one if people type in mobile repair, but we're not even on the list if they type cell phone. My store's been open for about 3 months, and we have about 17 reviews. We have a Yellow Pages, we have a Yelp, we have two different Facebooks, and it's got like 300 likes. And I was just curious, do you know anything about why that may be?
So it's all, I mean, a lot of it is, you know, the content that you have on your site. We'll play a lot to play with that. So, you know, we might have a lot lot of the keywords on your site are mobile repair, mobile this, mobile that, and it might not be geared towards having a cell repair in there. So that could be a big thing to so we talked about Yext. That's actually software that creates citations for you. So websites that you're going to show up on, things like directories and stuff like that, that you can add content to. That's, you know, it's really important to have content for every keyword. Like you said, like if you're adding the site content, adding that site content and everything's mobile, your top iPhone mobile repair, blah, 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 mobile, that's why you're going to show up for mobile. If you don't have the cell in there, you won't be showing up for cell as much. Because Google has to see things to take from. So if it sees cell repair on your website 4 or 5 times in different spots on different pages, it's going to say, okay, these guys do cell repair, we'll show up for this keyword. So it's kind of a very vague response to that. But
it is big. When you have a review, let's say you did a vacuum cleaner for somebody, right, and said, fix my vacuum. It's great, you got a 5-star review. But for somebody who searched iPhone repair, that review isn't going to be relevant for them, so it's not going to help your organic. So if you can get people to have reviews that say, awesome job on my iPhone repair for those specific keywords, that also helps.
One more question. Time for one more question.
Going back to scaling, I'm happy to throw $200 a day if I have a budget, if I have my AdWords budget, if that increases sales. And I do have my stores grouped, and one store is 75,000, one store is 35,000. I'd rather build up a $35,000 store, throw more money at that. But it's always been recommended to me not to exceed that. If you got a number of $60, I don't know how long it's been since you and I talked about it. You kind of just talk about that ceiling, that comfy $60 number you're talking about.
Yeah, I mean that's probably average. The stores are probably between $40 to $60 on the higher end, but there are stores that have the budget for it, that are growing, that have a competitive market, that need that extra money.
Like Fort Myers.
Yeah.
Well, I'm looking for your recommendation.
Yeah.
Population of Fort Myers.
Specifically?
Yeah, okay.
And what is some of your competition?
So, I mean, scaling is awesome, and, you know,
Google it.
More, if you throw, Google that's it. Not necessarily a guarantee that you throw more money in, you're going to get more sales off. We have to look at a bunch of different things. A lot of the benchmarking tools that I put out today, the conversion rates, how many conversions you're getting. If the conversion rate is there, if you're getting, you know, 10-12% of your people are converting, I would throw the money in all day. Because that means, you know, I have $20 more working for me to get 12% conversion. So,
Casey, I think he's talking about, you can touch on this real quick before we finish up. He was kind of talking about how he could spend more money, but you told him to hold off, maybe because he's not using all his budget. If you want to speak towards that?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's possible. I'd have to look at it more specifically because we manage a whole bunch of them.
But if we're not using them, maybe we can tweak the words or something.
Absolutely. There's different ways to set it. So, standard. This might be going to an if, but standard ads are going to show kind of evenly throughout the day. There's a way to set it to kind of like an accelerated version, so it's going to show it as quickly as possible to use out your budget. There's different settings we can tweak to make sure you're capitalizing on the customers.